Today, I'm going to talk about a project of evolution simulation. I've been thinking about this idea for a long time, yet I still couldn't figure out how they would breed. I started writing the code, and everything fell into place. These are two types of trees that appeared after 1,290 generations of evolution. Their genome is visible on the right. The genome is presented by 16 lines of four numbers. In the first generation, the genome was generated randomly. And next, the nature selection honed their shape to perfection, suiting a given environment. Let's have a look at the frames taken from one of the simulations. This should be the 10th generation. The trees are colored randomly. White cells are outgrowths that give birth to new cells. When a tree reaches its age limit, it disappears, while the outgrowths fall down to the ground, turn into seeds, and give life to new trees. 180 generations have already passed. One can see at least two types of trees with a smooth and stepped back. The trees get their energy from the sun. So if you cover the tree on the top, it will die. 300 generations have passed. The trees don't move, they just drop the seeds to one side here, causing such an effect. 1,300 generations have passed, and trees with a tree crown have appeared. Evolution occurs due to the fact that a new seed has a mutation with a probability of 25%. One of the numbers in the genome changes randomly. If the change turns out to be successful, the descendants of this tree are more likely to outcompete the representatives of other species. Well, this is the result of another modeling. Beautiful spruce trees appeared. All of this is just an initial concept. Everything is very simple here. The world itself is extremely small, only 256 squares wide. At any given moment, there are no more than a couple of dozen trees in this world. Now let's consider the environment where all this happens. The world is closed in a circle. Going beyond the left edge, it will appear on the right. This is the ground. This is the sun. The higher you get, the more sun energy you can get. These are levels to calculate how much energy the cell will receive at a given height. The sun can only penetrate three layers of cells. How much energy each layer will receive is calculated by applying this formula. The topmost layer receives the maximum energy. For example, this cell will receive 18 units of energy. Multiply level 6 by 3. In here, the top cell will receive 21 units of energy. Multiply level 7 by 3. Bottom 12, level 6 times 2. And so on. Any tree below three layers doesn't receive energy. Each turn, the tree spends 13 units of energy on each cell. Let's take a sample tree. It has 17 cells. Each turn, the tree loses 221 units of energy. And the tree will receive energy only from simple green cells. Since white cells, outgrowths, although they feed from a common boiler, save all the energy to create new cells. That's all. To survive in this world, you need be thin so as not to feed extra cells. Be tall to get more energy. Block the light to your neighbors to make room for offsprings. And scatter the seeds. Naturally, you can experiment with all these parameters. Now, how does the genome work? The genome consists of 16 genes. Each gene contains four numbers from 0 to 31. I colored the numbers from 0 to 15 in yellow. They define the direction of a new outgrowth and what kind of active gene it will have. Numbers over 15 don't count. Let's take a sample tree. The two lower cells are ordinary. The upper white cell is an offshoot. It has an active 11th gene. Let's look at the 11th gene. Here it is. The numbers in it mean that our offshoot should grow out three new offshoots, left, up, and right. And, respectively, they will have an active 8th, 6th, and 2nd genes. Here we have three new offshoots, as written in the gene. The original offshoot turns into a regular cell. A new circle begins. We take the left offshoot and active gene number 8. Here it is. According to this gene, we have a new offshoot with an active number 15. The next outgrowth is an active gene number 6. In this gene, all numbers are greater than 15. Therefore, when the outgrowth accumulates enough energy, it will turn into an ordinary cell and won't give new outgrowths. Let's take the next outgrowth, an active gene number 2. This gene instructs to give 2 new offshoots, down and to the right, with active genes 9 and 2. That's all, actually. The work of the genome is extremely simple and concise. Let's consider another example and take into account energy accumulation. Here we see the number of tree cells. The more there are, the more energy the tree spends on each move. The amount of energy is indicated here. If the energy is less than 0, the tree will die. This is the tree age. When the age reaches a number between 88 and 92, the tree will disappear and only sprouts will remain. They will fall to the ground, their gene number 0 will be activated, and they will give life to new trees. This is the initial seed. Each initial seed has an active gene number 0. The initial seed gave 3 new offshoots and turned into an ordinary cell. The left offshoot will turn into an ordinary cell without giving offspring. The upper offshoot will sprout upwards. The right offshoot should sprout down, but there is the ground, so it will just turn into a regular cell. Up, up, right, right. Now we have an offshoot with an active gene number 0. It should give 3 offshoots, but since the space on the left is taken, it will only give 2 new offshoots. One more move. Now there's an important point. This offshoot should sprout down, but since it is covered from above by 1 layer of cells, it needs to accumulate energy for 2 moves. So it has accumulated energy and gave a new offshoot. The new offshoot is now covered by 3 layers of cells. Therefore, it won't be able to accumulate energy to create new cells and will remain an offshoot. And when the tree reaches the age limit, this offshoot will turn into a seed, fall to the ground, and give life to a new tree. Well, our tree, meanwhile, continues to grow. In this case, we observe the same situation, and the offshoot simply doesn't have enough energy to create new cells. But at the next level, it's already higher. There is more energy. The offshoot manages to accumulate enough energy and gives new offshoots. Now the tree crown begins to grow. What else can be improved? First of all, you need to expand the world. You can add new commands to the genome. For example, so that the offshoot falls off and turns into a seed. The tree will scatter seeds as it grows. To enable the tree to change its lifespan related to energy, make an aggressive offshoot that cuts its own tree branches and other trees' branches. Well, that's all for now. Bye, everyone.